Go away.
Charles?
You said that as if you expected to find somebody else here.
You packing?
No, I'm going to have a tag sale later, and I'm taking inventory.
No, I mean, you're not going home for tomorrow morning.
Listen, when they come here with a wheelchair to escort me out of here, I don't want to keep them waiting any longer than's necessary. Two visits in one day? I didn't know I meant that much to you.
Oh, yeah, I didn't think I ought to let this wait very long. I stopped by Ms. Redlands. She agreed with me that somebody ought to read this letter from Miriam's son, and... Well, you being the next of kin seemed like the most suitable choice.
Hey, you. We love each other. He doesn't that count for something? Isn't that good enough?
No, it isn't. Russ, the love we have is not strong enough to hold us together.
I don't know if I like the way that sounds.
I don't either, but it's true. I just think it would be best if we stopped seeing each other for a while.
I don't want to stop seeing you.
I need time to think.
Okay, fine. Hey, take all the time you want, babe. Don't shut me out.
I have to go.
Hey, come on, Marion, wait. Listen, I'll drive you home, okay? I mean, I know you don't want to walk.
I'll take a taxi.
Marion, come on, let's talk. Come on, what are you doing?
Oh, Russ. Russ.
Open. Oh. Well, maybe it's not open then. Sorry about that.
Hi. I know I should have called first, but
Oh, no, don't be silly. The door's always open for you. Well, I mean, at least when it's unlocked anyway. What can I do for you?
Well, I guess I need to talk something out, and I just thought you'd be the best person to talk it out with.
Well, I'm honored, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to finish cutting up those vegetables while you do, though.
Well, I'd like to help.
Oh, Marianne, it's not necessary.
No, please, I insist.
Okay, but only if you agree to stay and eat dinner.
No, I don't think I...
Do you have other plans?
Well, no.
Now, I'm going to be doing the insisting. Please, I'd really enjoy it.
Well, it beats eating alone. No, I would love to, thank you.
Wonderful, come on.
I feel like I'm inviting myself, though.
Oh, nonsense.
Here you go. I assume all these vegetables are part of what we're having?
Mm-hmm. It's a combination Irish stew and Mexican soup.
Sounds interesting.
It is. It was Peter and Lori's favorite dish growing up. Scott hated it, though, so whenever he wasn't going to be home for dinner, we'd have it.
any news on Lori?
You haven't heard? She's being released from the hospital in a few days.
What? That's great.
Ben's in Fairmont now.
So they'll be home for Christmas.
Isn't it wonderful?
I'm so happy.
Oh, we all are. I really wasn't looking forward to Christmas this year, but now things are going to be a little bit better.
Yeah, I'm sure they will. You know, the first Christmas after Mom died was pretty rough. But things get better.
I know. Hey, you didn't come over here to talk about me. What's on your mind?
Oh, the usual.
Russ?
I think he and I are finally through, Mrs. Davidson.
You realize that I haven't seen my grandson in over a year?
Well, I'll be on my way.
Okay? No. Don't leave. I certainly wish he were here. He's going to get the Carpenter fortune one of these days.
What does he say?
Dear Mom, boy, was I surprised to get your letter. You sure sound different. I'm glad everything's working out okay for you. We're okay here, too. Well, pretty much okay. Dad has the flu. They call that grip here in England. I told Dad they should call it grump. That's what he is when he's sick. I like England pretty much, but they have rotten peanut butter. Dad says we can come to visit you. He wants you to write or give him a call. We could even come as soon as Dad's better. I'd like that. I miss all my friends. I miss Grandma and Grandpa, too. Tell them hello for me. Well, I guess that's it. Sincerely, Eric. P.S., how do you like my new name? P.P.S., I miss you a lot, Mom.
He sure sounds like a fine young man.
He is. I don't think there's anything more eloquent than a young boy speaking out of innocence. Harold, we have got to find Miriam.
Yeah, you just calm down. We'll find her.
I've been thinking about it, and if something is really wrong, if something has happened to her, I think that we should get Vince Cardello's help. After all, he has connections that we might be able to use.
I am way ahead of you on that one. I already talked to him.
You did? When?
A couple of days ago.
Well, what did he say?
Well, he had to do some checking.
Well, how much time does he need?
Well, gosh, I don't know. He didn't say.
Have you called him back? Have you touched base with him?
No, not yet.
Why not?
Well, okay, fine. I'll give him a call.
You don't handle this on the telephone. Harold, you go and see the man personally.
Fine, Charles, fine. I will. I'll see if he can see me tonight, okay?
All right.
Well, you just take it easy. Well, if you don't, I'll tell you something. They're not going to let you go anywhere tomorrow.
Why don't you start at the beginning, Marianne?
Yeah, I guess that's best. Well, Russ and I went out to dinner last night, and we had a nice enough time until we went to his townhouse. Well, I started asking him questions about what he'd do if he went to work for his father. He's always so vague about it. Anyway, whenever I try to get him to answer me, he tries to change the subject, usually by being romantic. Well, I guess, you know, I just didn't feel like putting up with that last night, and I told him so. And then one thing led to another, and before I knew it, I also told him that I wasn't comfortable with the fact that he wouldn't make a commitment faith-wise, and I thought that was hurting our relationship, too.
How did he take that?
Well, I think it took him by surprise. I didn't really give him a chance to answer because I kind of stormed out.
Kind of?
Well, I was mad, but he was, too. He slammed the door behind me when I left. I don't know. I'm so confused. I wish he'd call me, yet I'm glad he hasn't. You know, I really thought that the love I feel for him would be enough to change him.
Now you're discovering that that isn't too likely?
I don't know. How can I not believe in the power of love? I mean, God's love, to touch people's lives. It touched ours.
What are you really hoping for? I mean, just a second ago, you said that you hoped your love could change him.
Yeah, but doesn't he say that my love is only a reflection of God's?
Maybe, but he started this relationship on a very different level than you did. A very human level with very human feelings, including a strong sexual attraction. Now, I think you're experiencing confusion right now because maybe you're having many of these same feelings. Now, I'm not saying that that's wrong. I mean, this relationship is taking its natural course that any romantic relationship would take. But I think it's important that you determine right at the start those things that are essential to you two being compatible. Marianne, with your very strong faith in God, you need a man, a partner, who shares that same strong faith.
I know. That's what I keep praying for. I'm really worried about him now, Mrs. Davidson.
You make it sound as if he's in some kind of danger.
Well, that's exactly what I think. You know, I told you he's been so vague about what he'd be doing if he went to work for his father. Well, do you know who his father is?
Vince Cardello.
Do you know anything about him?
Well, I know that there was a rumor connecting him to organized crime, but rumors are rumors, and as far as I know, nothing was ever proven.
Well, perhaps, but what little I can put together seems to prove that those rumors are true. The most incriminating thing is this evasiveness by both Russ and his father about his father's job. Now, if what I think is true, then Russ being involved in all that would be horrible.
Well, maybe he won't take the job.
Well, I'm afraid he will. This obsession of his to be someone important and powerful, it's worse than ever. I mean, he's determined to have success at any cost.
I'm hoping and praying you're wrong, Marianne.
Well, so do I, but if my intuition is right, then the cost will be more than Russ can afford.
Thanks for seeing me on such short notice, Vince.
You sounded pretty desperate on the phone. What's going on?
Charles put two and two together and figured out there's probably foul play involved with Mary's disappearance.
I see.
Needless to say, he's pretty upset about it.
Still no request for a ransom yet from anywhere?
No, nothing. That's why I'm here. Interestingly enough, Charles came to the same conclusion about your contacts than I did. He wants to know if you've heard anything about Miriam.
No, not yet. There's still no word on the streets at all.
I was afraid that's what you were going to say.
Well, I still have a couple of people to talk to. And there's one or two sources that promised to dig deeper, but I wouldn't get your hopes up. It's very unusual in a kidnapping not to receive a ransom request by this time.
Yeah, I know. I realize that. I was just hanging on to the hope that maybe they realized he was still in the hospital and wanted to wait till he got home before they contacted him.
As I said, don't get your hopes up.
You're still going to help us, aren't you?
I may not be a lot of things, but one thing I am, I'm a man of my word. Also, I happen to be a father, so I sympathize with Charles. If she's still alive, I'll find her.
Like it?
Not bad.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm glad you could stay for dinner. You're gonna like what we're having. Mom, what do you call that stuff? Some sort of Hungarian Swedish goulash or something like that.
Something like that.
Yeah, it's my dad's favorite.
So, Peter, did Gil make any more crude remarks about women after I left?
Didn't give him a chance. I agreed with you and I left.
Well, good for you.
Yeah, well, your brother, he's really nice, but sometimes he can be such a jerk.
Peter, no, he's right, especially when it comes to the way he treats women. You know, Gil uses women like he does Amira to tell himself how wonderful he is.
Well, it takes two to tango.
I know, and believe me, I get really upset at all those girls for making fools of themselves over Gil. Do you know something, Peter? You're what every girl wants. A decent guy who will appreciate her instead of use her.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So I'm what every girl wants, huh? Then why is it I spend all my nights having dinner with my mom? And all the girls I seem to ask out have already said yes to the guys who want to use them.
Well, hang in there. You'll see I'm right.
Yeah. Well, I hope it happens before the turn of the century.
Believe me, it will happen before the turn of the century.
Okay. You know, I complain about Gil. You complain about Gil. We throw our hands in the air. We say how stupid he is. But you know what? He's never hurting for a date. He can have just about anybody, just like that, with moment's notice. Now he's got something going for him.
Well, look, what kind of girls are they?
Alluring, curvaceous, beautiful.
Peter, I'm serious.
So am I.
You know, you ought to hear one of those girls talk. If they ever had a deep thought, they'd probably drown in it. Everything is surface with them.
Beats playing solitaire.
Does it?
Yeah.
What does a relationship like that say about the people involved? That they're not mature enough to handle anything more profound than, hey, you look terrific, let's get together. Now, how satisfying can that be? I know what Gil does may seem attractive to you. But you know what, Peter? I can't remember him ever having a lasting relationship with anyone, especially one of his girlfriends. Now, that isn't very flattering. Excuse me, let me get off my soapbox.
No, that's all right. That's an interesting point of view. I know what you're saying is right, but nothing seems to work for me. Where are all the girls that want someone like me?
I don't understand. Are you saying that she's going to join us later at a restaurant?
No, she's not going to join us at the restaurant or any place else for that matter.
Well, why not?
Because I didn't invite her, that's why.
Don't I get to hear the reason why?
Hey, is it really that important to you? Come on.
No. You ready to go?
I didn't ask her to come along because of the questions she's been asking lately, that's all.
What kind of questions?
Guess.
She's a very persistent young lady.
Yeah, and you would have been the victim of her persistence if she'd have come along today. I just figured neither one of us were in the mood for that right now.
That curiosity of hers is not going to go away, you know.
If she keeps coming up against a brick wall, it will.
You don't seriously believe that.
I don't know what I believe anymore.
I think this all just shows that it would be a very big mistake for you to come to work for me.
Please, I don't want to rehash through all that right now, okay?
Fine. But one of these days, she's going to have to be told something.
Yeah, well, I'll cross that bridge when I come to it.
I think you've already come to it. See, I never had to face this problem. There was never any question about what Lisa's father did when I went to work for him. As far as your mother was concerned, it didn't make any difference to her.
Well, good. Then perhaps you could dig down real deep and muster up a little bit of sympathy for my situation, huh?
Oh, I have sympathy for it. I also have concern for you.
Well, I appreciate the concern, but you know where I'm at and you know where I've been. I got nowhere else to turn but you, Vince.
Yeah, I realize that. I want you to realize, though, that you can't have a job with me and Marianne, too. Are you prepared for that?
Who is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, turn around.
I want to see.
Oh, no, you know the rules around here. No peeking before Christmas.
I never did like those rules anyway.
Well, you like surprises, don't you?
Oh, I love surprises.
Okay, now you can turn around. Okay. Oh, no, turn around.
Mama.
Quit your complaining, honey. You'll see soon enough.
Is it safe yet?
It's all right now. You can turn around.
I love Christmas.
Well, it does bring out the best in people.
Yeah.
Well, most people anyway. Where you been all afternoon?
Around.
Oh, I see I'm not the only one around here with secrets.
Well, why should you have a corner on the market? This afternoon was so wonderful. I mean, the air was so brisk and the store was full of decorations and everybody was so friendly and nice.
Oh, I see. This secret you have must be awfully big, the way you're floating around here like a dandelion.
No, Mama, it's just like you said. This holiday brings out the best in all of us.
Oh, Carl, I'm so glad we're just spending it together. You know, these past Christmases have not been the same without you.
Yeah, I spent them crying my eyes out.
Oh, honey, we can thank the Lord that that's all in the past now.
Amen.
For crying out loud. So, Vince, if you don't want me to work for you, fine. Hey, just say so. It's okay by me. But don't continually give me all these cheap theatrics of yours all the time.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that's all I've been doing. But don't you think that by pretending something isn't there, that it isn't really there?
I'm not pretending that it isn't there. I'm just saying that I don't think that I have to make a choice between my job or Marianne, okay?
Then why are you here alone tonight?
You want me to call her? Is that what you want? You want to spend an evening with Marianne saying, hey, that was nice, Mr. Cardello, but could you go back to the original question?
Well, if you like.
Fine, I'll call her. Oh, you'd love that, wouldn't you? Yeah, that's exactly what you want, isn't it? Well, I'll tell you something. I bet you'd probably sit there and watch us and make me make a choice right in front of her. Well, I'll tell you something, Vince. I've already made my choice. I want both, and I'm gonna have both. And I'll tell you something, I really want to rest from all this tonight and just sort of relax, okay?
All right, I won't argue with that, but just satisfy my curiosity about something, will you? Are you telling me that Marianne is never going to find out what it is that you're doing?
No.
Well, then, are you telling me that when she does find out, it isn't gonna make any difference to her? Because that's very interesting, Russ. You know, we both know that she's a woman of very strong convictions. What is it she calls herself? A born-again Christian? Now, how do you suppose a born-again Christian feels about someone they love being involved in things like drug traffic and prostitution?
Those things are no different than the things that some of the most powerful men in this country have done to get themselves to where they are.
Well, I believe that. You do. But you're not a practicing Christian, and neither am I. What makes you think that Marianne is going to rationalize it the same way you do?
She loves me.
Answer my question.
All right. I think that in time, Marianne is gonna realize the key to our happiness is my success.
And if she can't realize that?
Fine. At that time, I'll admit that it's my fault. But I'll tell you something. It'll be her that had the greater loss. Now, if you don't mind, I'm real hungry. And I'd like to go out and just get something to eat right now, okay? Be all right?
You're on.
So you're really not going to tell me your little secret?
No.
Well, it looks like I'm just going to have to guess it.
I'll guess away, but my lips are sealed.
Oh, I know.
What?
You got another singing engagement.
You notice how I am drinking my tea and ignoring you?
That's not it. That's nice, but not enough to get you excited. I know. You and Jean are going on a second honeymoon as a special Christmas treat to each other.
You notice how I am still drinking my tea and ignoring you.
Well, if that's not it, it just should be.
It's not a bad idea, is it?
Carla.
What?
Sweetheart, come on. Tell me your little secret and I promise I won't tell a soul.
Oh, Mama, I'll tell you. But not until the right time.